Good morning, folks. Geoff Carter here. And you know what? It's 7:15 in the morning. Oh, I'll tell you something. I'm absolutely bog-eyed Bill again. Anyway, today's another move. Another plane. Another town. And that's why I'm up early. Got to catch the 10:05 flight to Bangkok. And then we're staying in Bangkok for a few days. But Ao Nang's been fantastic. And the hotel's been good as well. I'm going to show you around now and I'll give you some prices and things, but the location's fantastic. Yeah, pack the case, pack the bags, and then just moving on again. That's what it's all about, this travelling caper. You've just got to keep packing, unpacking, moving on, catching another plane, catching a taxi. Oh, it's all a go, but somebody's got to do it. So I'll just quickly show you the apartment now, or should I say the hotel room. And then we'll go downstairs and just grab a quick snack before the taxi comes. All right, so we've got a balcony there with two seats on and a small table made out of a log. There you go. And we're going to come inside now, and we've got the workstation there where you can put your laptop and that, and an aircon unit, but sometimes that drips, so you've got to watch it there. Got all the bags packed there, a few shelving areas. Around here, you've got a glass table and another chair and a big bed. And then we've got a flat screen TV, but that has got no English channels on it whatsoever. And it's run by Wi-Fi, and it never really worked all the time I was here. Large wardrobe. Here we go. And the all-important safety deposit box. Close that. And then we got the bathroom, toilet, sink, and we had a bath and a shower. But the shower was only like 4 foot tall, you know. And if you had a shower, even with the shower curtain, the bathroom would flood. But it's just one of them things, isn't it? It happens in other hotels. Got yourself a little fridge as well, and 2 bottles of free water every day. So let's go downstairs now and grab a snack, and I'll give you some prices. All right, and then we're gonna wait for the taxi, and then we're off to the airport. Right, we just sat outside the hotel now, and we've got fresh melon and pineapple, and then we got some pad thai, vegetables, couple of orange juice and a nice coffee, and all that is included. It's like a buffet breakfast, you know. You can help yourself. There's a tea and toast as well, and there's also pancakes, and it worked out per night 1,190 baht, and it's in a perfect location. You're probably 20 minutes walk from the beach and probably 12 minutes walk from the RCA center. And all the restaurants are down the main road here, and the small bars, etc. So this hotel is a really, really good location. And it's called the Ao Nang Eco Inn. There you go. And it's on most booking sites like booking.com, agoda.com, trip.com, Skyscanner. It's on them all. But what I did, I booked 4 nights here, and then I paid at reception, and you get it even cheaper. So that's what I'd do if I was you. I'd book it a couple of days if you like the location and the price. The staff are fantastic, the food's good, and for that type of money, I think it's a bob on location there. My mates, the Chatter guys, they're staying further down the road, and it's quite a bit of a walk up there. Theirs was a package deal from you know, from the travel agents, but it's always best if you book it independent like I do. Because if you don't like it after the 4 days, you can have a look round and book somewhere else, can't you? All right then, so I'm going to have this breakfast now, and then we're going to get my bags out of the room, and we're going to wait for the taxi to the airport. And this is the reception area and dining room. There you go. Lovely staff. And 24-hour reception service. a bit of a telly there for you. And then in here at the back is where the dining room is. You've got your tea and coffee, etc. There you go. But now it's 20 past 7 in the morning and the taxi should be here any minute now. So it's a case of just quickly finishing my coffee and we'll jump in the cab and we'll give you one of them, even at this early in the morning, because you love it when I do that, don't you? All right, see you in a minute. Right, so my taxi driver's just turned up. This is Wee. If you come in and you're landing at the airport, yeah, he may pick you up. But today he's very busy, so he sent his brother.
Yeah.
So we're going to get in his brother's car now. All right then, Wee.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, my friend.
Yeah, same, same.
Pop gan mai.
Pop gan mai.
See
yeah.
you soon.
See you soon.
Take care. Thank you.
Thank you. Come on.
See you, mate. Bye.
Bye.
And here's our driver for today. Hiya, mate. You okay? What's your name?
He's fine.
Oh, that's good. Right, let's get in the car, eh? So we're off to the airport now, and the fee to the airport, because it's about 45 minute drive, is 600 baht from the hotel, but you can get it for cheaper, 500, but I like to keep everything in-house, keep it nice and simple, especially when it's this early in the morning and you've got to rely on the taxi turning up. So yep, we're just going to head to the airport now and everything's hunky-dory. Hey, hunky-dory, I've never said that before. Right, I'm looking forward to this.
Bye-bye.
See you soon. Thank you. Bye. Well, that's not bad timing. It took us about 40 minutes, so just going to go inside the airport now, check the bags in, and then we're going to sit down and relax and wait for the flight. All right? Huh. All this up and down, back and to, packing, unpacking. But it's all part of travel. All right, see you in a bit. Whoops-a-daisy, look at this lot here. Well, that was easy. It took me about 10 minutes to check in because I checked in online yesterday. So if you want to avoid the queues, make sure if you've got access to a computer or your mobile phone, make sure you're checking online and you'll bypass the big crowds. We're off now already. Amazing. And here we are. Everybody waiting for the planes now. There you go. You wouldn't believe that. That was so quick. Unbelievable. And all the people in immigration, you know, at Manchester Airport, they're pushing and shoving. Yeah, take your laptop out, do this, do that. Them people there then were so polite. It was unbelievable. Just dead, dead calm. Would you like to put your laptop in there, please? Would you like to put that in there, please? Thank you. Please and thank you. Manners don't cost a thing. So, just going to plonk down now and wait for the flight. So here we are now, just waiting for the flight. We're at gate 7 here at Krabi Airport. And the reason I bought Bangkok Airways is because on the way here it was only £53. And on the way back it's a little bit more expensive. I think it's £126 back to Bangkok. But don't forget, within that price, you get 20 kilos luggage, which you don't get with most of the other airlines. You have to pay extra. And you get 7 kilos on board, you know, with your rucksack or whatever. And also, when you're flying in from Bangkok, you can go into their VIP lounge for free. Free! We love it when it's free, don't we? Right, let me tell you about it. They won't tell you. You check in, you go through domestic, and then you go past loads of places where you can buy food. No, don't matter even what gate you're flying out at. Go to gate A3, and opposite gate A3 is the lounge. And all you've got to do is show your boarding pass. It's free to get in, and when you get in there, there's tea, coffee, fruit juice, water, there's pasties, there's pies, there's sandwiches, fresh fruit and little rice cakes and free internet, and it's a nice quiet lounge. So if you get to Bangkok Airport long enough, you can sit there and relax and have loads of free food. So I had loads. I thought, you know, we've got an hour and a half flight now to Krabi. No, you get on the plane and you also get an in-flight meal. So I chose Bangkok Airways better than any of the other ones. I've studied them, and I know it's a little bit more expensive flying back, but I'm not bothered, because by 4 o'clock today, I'll be back in Bangkok, in my hotel, bags done and dusted, and out on the Big Mango. And I might just be heading to the Stumbling, which is my favourite little bar at tea time, people watching. So it's all good stuff. I think we've got about another hour now before we get on the plane, and the journey only takes 90 minutes, which is fantastic. So yeah, I would suggest, if you're using the airlines, I'd have a look at Bangkok Airways, because you can get some really good deals. I could have got a cheaper flight if it had gone tonight, but then you've missed a day, haven't you? So I paid a little bit extra, so I could come this morning. I could be in Bangkok, well, get to the airport at 25 to 12, and the plane takes off here, I think, at 10:05. So we've not got long to wait now, and I've got a window seat as well, right at the front. So it's all good stuff. All right, catch you in a bit. Just waiting for a few more passengers to come on board now, and we're off to Bangkok. I'm in row 2, and I got a window seat as well, so we'll film taking off. But we're just waiting for the last few passengers to come on now, and then we'll be on our way. 90 minutes, we'll be in Bangkok. We're here, Bangkok. That time flew by. See what I did then? So, collect the bag now, and then I think what we're going to do is catch the train and the Sky train down to Narna. So yeah, just go and collect the bags now, and away we go. Right, we're going down to the basement level now, to catch the first of two trains. One's from the airport to, I think it's called Pattaya Thai, and then the next one is the BTS Sky train, and that'll take us right into Narnak, and that's where we want to be going. So, and it's only cheap as well, and it's quicker than getting a taxi, especially in daytime traffic through the heart of Bangkok. So yeah, we'll just keep going down to the basement level, and then we're off. So we're now on the basement level, and we're off now to catch the first of two trains. The first one's the airport link, and then that joins onto the sky train, takes us right into Narnak in Bangkok. So we'll just get the first ticket, and then away we go. So the first leg of the journey costs 45 baht, and that takes you to Pattaya Thai station, and that's where you change for the BTS Sky train, and you get one of these, and then we jump on the train, and then we get off at the end. Okay, so we've just arrived now at Pattaya Thai station. I was saying Pattaya Thai before, wasn't I? What am I lying? I'm always getting my words mixed up. Don't matter, does it? Anyway, we're at Pattaya Thai station now, and you've got to buy another little token now, and that'll take you on the BTS Sky train down to Narnak. Okay? And now, we didn't get a token this time, we got a card, and it's 35 baht all the way from here now to Narnak Plaza. Okay, so we'll see you when we get there. Exciting stuff. We made it, folks. We're on Sukhumvit in Bangkok, and I hope we give you some good little tips there, getting from Krabi all the way back to Bangkok and then on to Sukhumvit. Money saving tips and good airline tips, and that whole journey then took about 40 minutes, and it was only 80 baht. If you get a taxi, it takes you about an hour and a half and about 800 baht. So yeah, I do the work and you can just benefit from it. Right, listen, I'm going to go to the hotel now, check in, have a quick shower, and then I'm out. I'm going to stumble in for my lovely 100 baht for draft Chang beer. And I think it's well deserved after that journey, don't you? Okay, if you like the movie, give us a thumbs up. There's no thumbs down today. Leave your comments below, and don't forget to subscribe. And hit the little bell. We love it when you do that, don't we? And you know what I'm going to say now? From a very busy Sukhumvit. And the main thing is, keep smiling!